Burgers, Captain Kenny here. We're going to make some buffalo chicken strips tonight, East Side style. Y'all stay tuned. We're going to use some boneless, skinless chicken breast, cut them up in strips, and then fry them like I like them, and then put a little bit of Frank's Red Hot on them. Y'all stay tuned. Somebody been using my knife. Probably need some eyeballs here. Feels kind of dull. Almost looks like the tip is rounded off. Oh yeah, that's it there. Okay. We're good to go and do this again. Okay. That's more like it. I'm gonna cut the fat off here. Make real big ones. They're going to be more like bite-sized pieces. And I'm cutting across the grain. I don't know how tender these chickens will be, but they're going to be tender when I get done with them. These aren't real complicated, they're pretty simple. But you do want to make sure you get enough oil in there or else it'll burn really quickly. Okay, what we're going to have is we're going to have an egg bath with seasoned flour. 5 eggs. You can add some milk to it if you want to, but I'm not going to because I don't have any. But sometimes, you know, you just have to use what you have at the house. I'm not making a special trip to the store to go get a little bit of milk to put in there or a little bit of buttermilk. I mean, it'd be nice, but you don't have to. I like using what I've got. Down to about 3/8. Now these are a tad frozen still. I mean, they're just barely. have just kind of a breading station over here. Be careful when you're doing this, because you could drop one of those chicken pieces in there and burn yourself, because that oil is pretty daggum hot. Now, the reason I call this the East Side Chicken Tenders is because we use just what we got. If we ain't got it, we don't use it. That's how we roll on the East Side. just cooking these till they're golden brown, which isn't a long time. Because remember, I did pound them flat. Now, I haven't got to make a video in the last 2 weeks. Or edit videos, which I'm behind on that also, because I filmed a friend of mine's wedding. And I cooked 8 briskets for it. So, y'all stay tuned. And the video for the briskets will be out probably within a month. That wedding video took a lot of time to lay out. It was over 5 hours of video. Once I get all these fried up, I'm going to pop them in the oven to keep them warm. I'm going to set the oven at 200 degrees. Now it's time to thank one of our sponsors. Thank you. Cooled down just a little bit. .44, .45. Need about 30 more degrees. Wife happy, because this is exactly what she wanted for dinner. Oh, those look so good. That one's a little thicker. Pretty good. That extra little beating I gave those chickens made them nice and tender. Otherwise, they would have been kind of chewy. Scrum dilly issues. They're good just like this. Turn the video camera on. So what we've got is about a cup and a half of Frank's red hot sauce. We don't have real butter, so we're going to use some country crock. To it. Probably 1-2 tablespoons. A little bit of brown sugar. About a quarter of a cup. Something my wife doesn't like. Put a little honey in it. What do you say, Godric? Huh? Godric, are you you ready for your dinner? Huh? He's a big boy. Are you ready for your dinner? Huh? You like being on camera, don't you? Hey, you ready for dinner? You ready for dinner, aren't you? You gonna eat dinner early tonight? That's what I thought.
Perfect.
Everything's ready? Once the wife gets home, we'll cover them with some of that red hot sauce, mix them up, all that goodness, and we're gonna try them and dig in. Y'all stay tuned. Frank's Red Hot Sauce Chicken Tenders. Boneless Buffalo Chicken. Mmm. Just like Hooters. Cider Buffalo Chicken. That's how we do things. This is Captain Kenny signing off, Smokehouse Barbecue. Y'all stay tuned. Please subscribe. Hit that little bell. Comment down below. I'll get back to you.